choir. It's your time to come in soft now. Come on.
Hello, hello, hello. Good morning, good morning, good morning, everybody. This is the day that the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. Top of the morning to you. You and you, whomever you are, wherever you are, the blessing of the Lord rest upon you mightily. It's good news from Zion. Pastor Howard Palmer here with you from a cool, cool New York City. Good morning, Jamaica. Good morning. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name, who forgiveth all thy sins and healeth all thy diseases. It's September 16, 2023, right here on Best 100 FM, 100.1.3.5.7.9 on the FM dial. We are coming at you, coming at you. Let's go, let's go, let's go. All across the beautiful fruited plains of the island home of Jamaica, from the fisherman to the mountain man, it's gospel, gospel, gospel.
Lion of Judah, we worship you. Lion of Judah, you are holy. Can we sing together? Lion of Judah. Mama, baby.
Lion of Judah, Lion of Judah, roar, roar. In these last days, in these trying and evil days, O Lion of Judah, roar, roar, Lion of Judah. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, rulers of the darkness of this world, spiritual wickedness in high places. And we got to have God's divine protection upon our lives. So we're dealing with forces, unseen forces, powers of darkness, the Bible says, wicked spirits in high places. We got to have the Lion of Judah among us. The Lion of Judah has to be with us. Moses said to God, he said, if you don't go with us, carry us up not hence. Don't take us from here. If you're not going to come with us, my God. God told Moses, I'm going to send you an angel to go with you. And Moses said, yeah, thank you for the angel. But if you yourself don't come with us, oh Lord God, do not carry us, don't move us from here. Don't move us from here if you're not coming with us. The man had a desperate dependence and reliance upon God. Come on now. We're dealing with some ancient devils, powers and principalities and rulers and wickedness. We need an ancient touch of God, an ancient move of the Spirit to clean out and clear out, to pull up and pull down, to, come on now, tread upon and trample. We're dealing with serious powers and principalities of darkness. We're dealing with it in our homes, in our churches, in our neighborhood, in our communities, on our jobs. Come on now. We as a people are dealing with serious attack from the enemy. Powers of darkness and forces of the enemy has been unleashed upon the land. My God, we need for God to go with us. Jamaica, listen to me. We need for God to go with us. What we're dealing with is not normal. It's not regular. No, no, no. The level of evil and violence and wickedness and barefacedness. In Jamaica, we say barefaced. Right in your face, brawling daylight. Oh, come on now. Come on now. Hear what the Bible says. It says principalities and powers in high places. See, this is where Satan pitches tent and set up his office, his headquarters. It's among those who are in high places. Do you hear me? Wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, against the rulers of darkness, against spiritual wickedness in high places. That's where the devil set up his camp. High places. Places of decision. When you have a group of people that has power to make decision over other people's lives. That's where Satan set up his camp. Come on now. Forces of darkness is unleashed upon the land. We have leaders who have lost the fear of God. Men who are not praying, women who are not seeking God. But privately, they are the synagogue of Satan. Oh, don't you hear me what I say? I said privately, they are the synagogue of Satan. They are Satan's habitation. They look like us. They grew up among us. They were born in the same island like us. They went to church in some years ago like us. Went to school like us. Climb mango tree like us. Drink coconut water like us. But something has entered them at some point in their lives, and internally they are not like us. Come on now, somebody. Come on now. There's a whole lot of forces of darkness twirling and swirling around in the pond of Jamaica, in the pool of Jamaica. There are all kind of spirit coming in from overseas and devils. They bring their foreign gods with them. It's a whole lot. Just think about it for a minute. It's a whole lot. A spiritual activity taking place in Jamaica. Devils and demons that we never had to deal with, some of these devils. It was not a big problem. It was not a major issue in years gone by. And now I'm telling you, the place is tied up. This is a job for the intercessors. That's the solution that God has given us. This is a job for the intercessors. Come with me this morning. Come with me this morning. Good morning to you. The program is Good News from Zion. Pastor Howard Palmer here with you. Right here on Best 100 FM. Standing guard. Manning my post. And by His grace, trying to inspire you to do the same. Stand guard over your neighborhood, over your community. Come on now. Stand guard over your community where you live. Pray every devil out of there. Plead the blood on a regular. It's going to take old-fashioned godliness to drive out these forces of darkness that comes to prevail over us. Lion of Judah, Lion of Judah, you are holy. The righteous of all earth, the righteous of all earth. I'm trying to provoke you now. I'm trying to provoke you and wake you up in the spirit. I'm trying to provoke you and wake you up in the spirit and say, we cannot sleep now. We cannot slumber now. We cannot act like a tourist on the beach. Like everything is all right. Come on, somebody. This devil is after your children. This demon is after your children. Do you hear me what I tell you? The devil has placed his disciples. It was a couple months ago I preached a message, Antichrist disciples. Antichrist disciples. And in that message I said, Satan is placing certain people whom he has possessed in strategic areas of society. And I name a couple of the areas of society. In the media is one of them. Satan has his people in the media. Satan has his people in various governmental departments. There are people working in government that are Satanists. And even if they don't bow the knee and worship that devil, they carry out satanic behavior. Do you hear me what I tell you? And what they're trying to do is to convert you and your children and your community and the nation. They want us to come the way of Sodom and Gomorrah. Wake up, I'm talking to you. I am talking to you. It bothers me to know that over 800 teachers have resigned. The question is that who is going to take the space of these teachers that have resigned? Come on, parents, I'm talking to you now. There is a fight for the soul of Jamaica. I preached that message too. Months and months ago, I preached that message. There is a battle for the soul of Jamaica. If you go to YouTube and type it in, Pastor Howard Palmer, battle for the soul of Jamaica, it will pop up. I've been warning you and telling you, changes are coming for the worse. My God, I just want you to pray with me this morning and just come with me this morning. You know you told me. Satan wants the mind of your children, wants the heart of your children. A perverted spirit has taken over the world. It is rampant here in America. A perverted spirit. Man with man and woman with woman. And some of them even turn into their dogs. The literal puppy dog animals. Bestiality I'm talking about. It's dreadful and terrible out there in Babylon. Hey, yo, bo shata la bako saya. But come make we chant down Babylon now. Grandmama, before she passed away, she chant down Babylon. She kept Babylon at bay. Oh God, we have lost some really good. You know, last night I was coming home, this morning actually, driving home, and I was thinking about a lady, Mother Foster. Mother Foster. Anybody know Mother Foster? That lady had a great impact upon me when I was a young man in my late teens, early 20s. We need people like that, that travel with their hymn book and their Bible. And they were always sharp in the spirit. No matter if you catch them in the middle of the day, washing their clothes, they were sharp in the spirit. There are some people who have gone on before us. And since they have left, the atmosphere shift for the worse. Let me say it again. There are some people that have gone on before us, and since they left, the atmosphere shift for the worse. It's as if the anointing that was on them kept the devil at bay. But since that, they have gone on to be with the Lord. We're dealing with things that we never had to even talk about. It was never there. It was there but hidden. Now everything that was hiding in the closet is coming out like gully wash, bang to bang. But I believe the blood still work. I believe the name of Jesus still work. I believe that prayer still work. I believe the old-fashioned Bible still work. And if God can find a few people that will stand flat-footed for Him, point your prophet finger in the face of the devil and tell him you're going to back up. You're going to back down, back way, and go away. Oh, you're both Shanda Nabakosaya. My God, if God can just find a few in Sardis who have not defiled their garment, to point your prophet finger in the face of the devil and tell him, say, back up, back down, back where, and go where. In the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody, come on. You don't know what I've been through for the past 3 months. The past 3 months has been very, very challenging for me. And I want to thank God for my armor bearers who kept it together, Minister Norman Lamond, and those who, you know, prayed and kept it together. But it has been very challenging for me for the past 3 months, 2.5 months to be exact. But God is good in spite of it all. Satan hate this radio ministry. Satan hate this radio broadcast. Because you see, when God put us here to minister, the cockroaches are uncomfortable. They start running. Because we shine light. The Bible says that the sons of Issachar were men of understanding who knew how to speak the word of God in season. They knew what time it was.
I want you to
and knew how to speak the word of God. The atmosphere over Jamaica has changed. I want you to hear me this morning. I don't have any particular sermon plan or anything. I am just going by the burden that's upon my heart. The atmosphere over Jamaica has changed. Jamaica is lusting after the European way of life, the lifestyle of the Europeans and the liberal Americans. Jamaica is lusting after their lifestyle. There are people who are in Jamaica, who were born there, grew up there. Some of them were living overseas, and they have joined their forces together to change the culture, the trajectory, the direction of our country. Listen to what I am telling you. They are powerful people that wants to change the trajectory of our country, the culture. We are known for certain things. And the vast majority of the Jamaican people will not tolerate certain things. They will not tolerate it. And there are politicians, members, even members of parliament that would want to take the country in a certain direction that matches their lifestyle and their behavior. There are people in the media, in government. I've been saying these things to you for months. Go back and listen to the tapes on YouTube. You will hear, you will see it for yourself. But now it has gotten serious, very serious. Come on, somebody. I want the parents, you better rise up and listen to me. Some of you are going to have your children coming home to you, and physically they look like you. Physically you can say, yes, you look like a mother, a father, his father, whatever. But when they open their mouth, they don't sound like you anymore. They don't sound like their grandmother anymore, because a spirit has entered them and directed their minds in a different direction. In the name of Jesus Christ this morning, I want you to open up your ears and perk up yourself and hear what the Spirit is saying to you. It's a serious time we're living in. We're living in a time where just before Noah's flood, just before the flood of Noah, just before the flood of Noah, that's where we are right now. We mean seconds away from the flood of Noah, seconds away from the rapture of the church. The church is going to be raptured. God is going to take the church out of the world. And there will be a time when Antichrist will show up on this earth. We are approaching the season of Antichrist's reign upon the earth. That's where we are right now. That is why you see all the restlessness going on in the world. That is why you see all the change of lifestyle, and people want to say they are of a different gender and all kind of stuff going on in society, because the spirit of Antichrist has gotten closer to be revealed, to be manifested. There is a man coming. I know the devil don't want me to talk like this. I know the devil want me to come here with some butter bread for you and some chocolate tea with some cream on top of it. The devil is a liar. He wants me to come up in here this morning and sweet talk you. Give you something sweet, some sweetie pie kind of talk. But the blood prevail. I'm giving you hard stuff this morning. Wake up and perk up yourself. Don't get yourself tied up into this world. This world is going to go to hell. The world is not going to be saved. All of you preachers and evangelists who are trying to save the world, you're wasting your time. The world is not going to be saved. The world is going to go to hell. Let me tell you what is going to be saved. God is going to go into the world, and he is going to save some people that will listen to him and bring them out of the world and put them in the kingdom of God. He's doing that right now. Do you hear me? I said the world, as you know it, the world outside there, is not going to be saved. You hear me? Isaiah said hell has enlarged in itself. The amount of people going to go to hell, hell has enlarged in itself. That's what Isaiah said. So the attempt to try and save the world is a vain attempt. It's vain. God is going to touch individuals who are in the world. Some of you are listening to me right now. God is dealing with your heart, and there are people that are going to respond to the gospel. And while you have a group of people responding, there will be a group that's going to reject the gospel.
I want you to stand up.
No matter how much you preach to them, no matter how much dreams and vision God gives them, they will not repent. Keep your radio on. Keep your radio tuned up and turned up. I have a lot more to say to you. So much things to say right now. So much things I want to say to you right now. I said I have so much things to say to you right now. Jamaica, I want to let you know I truly love you. My fellow Jamaicans, I truly love you. Brothers, my Jamaican brothers, I truly love you. My Jamaican sisters and mamas, I love you. But we are losing our way. We are losing our way of life. The atmosphere, listen to me this morning, and this is where I'm going to anchor my boat. The atmosphere over Jamaica has changed, has shifted. Not for the better, but for the worse. And this is the job of the preacher, to come and show the people the difference between light and darkness, wrong and right, good and evil, between Satan and God. To come and show you, say, listen, don't go down that road now. Take a stand. Once again, we see the Europeans trying to colonize the world. Do you hear me? It's called cultural colonization. The Europeans, once again, is colonizing the world as we know it. They're going into Africa and telling them, you must let two men get married. If you don't do this, we're going to take away aid from you. Aid. They steal Africa's gold. They steal Africa's minerals. And when they want Africa to do what they want Africa to do, they say, if you don't do what we tell you, we're going to take away aid. Aid that they aid that they get from the gold that they stole from Africa. So the very aid they're giving Africa is from something that they stole from Africa. They're still stealing today. They're still stealing. They're still raping and robbing Africa today, these Europeans. They love to go into Africa and threaten the African leaders and tell them, you must do this. You must do that. You must do what we tell you. But thank God for these African men. They stand up bold and tell these Europeans, get out of here. You get out of here. We're not interested in that kind of way of life. We have a tradition. We have a history. And we're not going down that road with you, you Europeans. We're not going down that road with you. Oh my God. Listen to me. The Bible says in the book of Revelation, he spoke of a place in Europe called Pergamos. It's right there on the border between Asia and Europe. Over there in Turkey, somewhere there. There's a place called Pergamos. And God said in the book of Revelation, this is where Satan's seat is. This is where Satan's seat is. On the face of the earth, geographically speaking, there is a place where the devil operates from. The Bible call it Pergamos. Go look it up. Pergamos. P-E-R-G-A-M-O-S. Go look it up. He said, this is where Satan's seat is. He's speaking in a spiritual context to say, spiritually speaking, there's a particular place on earth where the devil operates from. And that's right there in the European continent on the border with Asia. And this is why you see so much things start in Europe and then it filters to America and then it spreads all over the world. What they call world war, because in actuality it wasn't even a world war, it was a continental war. But because they think they own the world, they call it world war. But let's use that word for the sake of argument. There have been two world wars. Both of them started in Europe. By Europeans fighting Europeans. In World War II, over 60 million white people died in Europe. Over 60 million. Russia alone lost over 26 million people in World War II. It's a blood-soaked continent. And there's a spirit over there that hates God. Hates God, the living God, the real God, the true and living God. There's a spirit in Europe that hates God. And they're the ones pushing the Sodom and Gomorrah lifestyle. I am going to say it. I don't know what you call this, if it's preaching or teaching, but I'm talking to you and I'm talking the truth to you. The Europeans are the ones today pushing the Sodom and Gomorrah lifestyle. Not the Asians, not the Chinese, not the Japanese, not the Koreans, not the Africans. But the Europeans are the ones doing it. We need to call it out as it is. His name is Mr. Jesse Dixon. Take it from the top one more time. Good morning, everybody. It's good news from Zion. Pastor Howard Palmer here with you. It has been a long time since I've been with you live in studio. I'm here with you this morning. It's the 16th day of September, 2023. And I have been longing to talk to you. I miss you. Yes, I miss you, my dear precious listeners. I miss you. I know you tuned in. I know you tuned in. But we're here, and as time goes on, I'll give you a testimony as to what God has helped me with the other day and gave me favor and just helped me. He helped me. A difficult period, a difficult 2.5 months, but God helped me. The devil, he doesn't want me on the air. He wants to shut me down, shut me up, and he does not want me on the air. I am telling you, the devil hates my voice. He doesn't want me on the air. He doesn't want me in ministry. Because when I open my mouth to talk, you cannot Listen, you cannot laugh, nor jeer, nor mock, or play joke with my words. You're either going to be affected positively, or you're going to run. But you will never be able to laugh at my talk when I talk. Because I'm not talking no nonsense. I'm not talking no garbage. I'm talking to you. The word of God, the truth of God's word, giving you perspective and background as to what is going on. Maybe next week, Saturday morning, I'm going to talk to you on the topic, Black people are programmed to self-destruct. That's what I really was thinking of talking to you about this morning, but the spirit shifted. But one of these Saturday morning, maybe next week, I want to talk to you on the theme, Black people are programmed to self-destruct. I don't want to touch that now. That's a whole different story right there. A whole different unction. I don't want to touch that now. That is too heavy. But we're talking about what we're talking about this morning. Why is it that we see so much shifting and changes taking place in our country? If you don't agree with nothing that I've said so far, you must agree that the atmosphere over Jamaica has changed. The atmosphere over Jamaica has changed. Let me turn off the music and really get into this thing. You have to agree that the atmosphere over our country has changed. Look at the amount of young ladies you see walking around acting like they're men. Go to Halfway Tree, go to wherever, and look on this, on the people walking on the sidewalk. Look at the Jamaican people. Look at the ladies, the females. They are dressing and acting like men. Look at the young brothers. Look at them. Don't you see that this is something that we have never used to see before? What's going on? What is going on is we are approaching the time of the reveal of the Antichrist. The Antichrist is about to be revealed in the earth. There is a man coming, and the Bible says he's coming from the west. That's what the Bible said. It says there's a he-goat pushing from the west. The Antichrist will be a man from the European continent. I am 100% sure about this. He is coming from the European continent. That's where Satan's seat is. Pergamos. Go look it up in Revelation. I think it's Revelation chapter 3, if I'm not mistaken. He says that there's a place in the European continent, the border with Asia, that is called Pergamos. And Jesus said this is where Satan's seat is. There is a man that is going to rise up in Europe. A couple in Europe going to have a baby. And that baby will be Satan in the form of human flesh. 100% Satan in the form of human flesh. And he will rise up at a time in the world where there will be international crisis. There will be a need for him. There will be topsy-turvy, there will be restlessness, unrest, protests, a civil war taking place in the world. There will be chaos. The world going to go through a chaotic period where every nation, people will be crying out for somebody to do something about this. This chaos, this famine, this lack of food, this lack of, you know, the necessities of life. And there will be international chaos. It's coming. When this thing comes, the world is going to cry out for a man, somebody to do something about it. So in other words, there will be a need for somebody to show up to solve the problem. It will be in this situation, a man will show up. And the Bible describe him and say he's going to be a great orator, somebody who can talk very well, a very strong, charismatic personality, a magnetic personality, that people are going to be drawn to him. The Bible says he's going to understand dark sentences, he's going to have a brilliant mind, and he will be able to solve economic problems. His three main problems he's going to solve. And when he solves these three problems, the whole world is going to go after him. The first one he's going to focus on is the economies of the world. He'll merge the economies of the world into one. and he will solve economic problems. He will solve the problem of poverty, hunger, and lack. He's going to solve that problem. Then he's going to solve the religious problem, because mankind always war over three main problems from Adam until today. It's economics, then you have religion, then you have politics. Those are the three problems that plague the human race from the fall of Adam until now. Economics. People have to eat. People have to drink. People have to sleep. People need a roof over their head. They need food for their families. And they have to live as a decent human being. People have been fighting for years for economic freedom. Economic stability. This man is going to bring that economic stability. Everybody may not be rich during that time, but everybody will be satisfied. Everybody will be comfortable. They will have the basics of life. Then he is going to bring political, let me leave that one for the last. He will bring religious harmony. He will merge the religious groups, the various religions. He will merge them into one. Islam, Christianity, Judaism, Buddhism, all of these religions will be merged as one. One religion. There's a thing in New York called interfaith. You see, when you understand these things from the Bible, you can see traces of it even beginning from now. And so the third one is politics. From the beginning of time, man has been fighting over who would be king, who would rule the land, who will rule over who. And wars have been fought over political differences. He will solve that problem. He will cause the whole political scenery to come under one umbrella in unity, everybody living together in peace and safety. This is where the scripture fulfilled, where Jesus says, when they think it's peace and safety, sudden destruction. Because the Bible says he only has 7 years. The first 3.5 years, the Bible said, through peace, he shall destroy wondrously. So in other words, the first 3.5 years, he's going to be the nicest guy you ever meet. Those of you that are going to be here, because I won't be here, I'll be caught up with the Lord in the rapture. I have no desire to see this brute, this wretch, this going to hell, Simba-knighted, condemned hypocrite. I don't have no desire to see him. He is Satan in the flesh. Gosh. Do you hear me what I said? He is going to solve the political problems of this world. Let me name them again. It's economy, then religion, then politics. These are the three main problems he will solve in the space of 3.5 years. This man will bring a calm and a prosperity the world has never seen. You see, just as though you had the worldwide pandemic, COVID, and it affected everybody in the world. That's exactly how this guy, when he comes on stage and implement his policy, it will affect everybody at the same time. If everybody will be affected, he pass a law or he suggests a law to be passed, it will be done overnight. And when people see the result, that's when they're going to be more drawn to this guy. Antichrist I'm talking about. The word anti means against. He's against Christ. He hates God. He's the devil in the flesh. Very brilliant, very handsome, very magnetic, very charismatic. The Bible said the whole world is going to go after him. And so these three problems, he will solve them in 3.5 years. At the end of the first 3.5 years, he has won the hearts of the entirety of the world, the majority of the world. He has won their hearts. Come on now. And then in Thessalonians, we see something happen. Paul says, he shall go into the temple of God and there declare himself as God. So we know the temple, the Jewish temple that Solomon built, is going to be rebuilt in Jerusalem. We know this. How we know it? Because Paul said he will go into the temple of God. There is no temple of God right now. So at some point during that period, he will allow the Jews and the Arabs to come up with an agreement, an understanding, an agreement, a peace agreement, that the Jews will be allowed to rebuild their temple beside the Muslim mosque over there in Israel. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. You all better join me in the mornings, man, for manna in the morning. I have so much thing to say. I can't say it all in 2 hours. Join me every week. I'm back hot and ready. I'm back with my mouth trembling. I'm back ready to go. Because I see for the past 2.5 months, the devil wants to shut me up and shut me down. He want to bring sickness in my body. He's coming at me from every angle. And prayer warriors, we're going to pray this morning. Don't worry. Let me just go with the flow, and we'll pray a little bit later. The devil trying to shut me up, shut me down. The devil trying to destroy me. He doesn't want to. You see this kind of talk I'm talking now? Some of you haven't heard this kind of talk in all your Christian life. In all your life as a human being, you haven't heard nobody talk like this. And I'm not giving myself no praise here. I'm just saying to you that there are people that God has anointed for particular purpose. And this is one of the area that God has anointed me to talk about. That Bible you have in your house there is not a joke book. That's why they ban it from schools in Europe. And they ban it from schools here in America. You can carry every book, every other religious book to school except the Bible. Do you know that? In California, they gave the Muslim student a private area to go and pray 5 times a day in California. But the Christian cannot find not even one second to pray in that same school. They banned Christianity. Why would they ban the Bible? Have you ever thought of it? What is it about the Bible that Harvard is afraid of? Yale University, Columbia University, Oxford University in England. What is it about the Bible they are afraid of? That they ban it? Because the revelation of the living God is in that Bible. There's something in that Bible that disturbs the perverted of our generation. The reprobate of our time is tortured and tormented just by thinking about the Bible. I don't want to get off into that. Let's come back over here. This Antichrist, this Satan in the flesh, he's going to get the Jews and the Arabs, the Muslims, to come to a peace agreement that the Jews will be allowed to rebuild the temple. And the temple will be rebuilt within the first 3.5 years. How do I know this? Because what is going to start the Armageddon war? Alright? And let me explain Armageddon to you. Armageddon is a literal place in Israel. It's a valley. It's between Israel, Lebanon, and Syria. There's a valley there. An open chasm in the earth. A valley. Right now they're doing farming in that valley. I've driven through that valley on tour buses. I went there 2 times and they drove us through that valley. It's also called the Jezreel Valley. But the right name for it is the Valley of Armageddon. Alright? In the Valley of Armageddon, the Bible said 200 million men will gather to battle the end of days battle called the Armageddon War. So the name of the valley is called the Valley of Armageddon, and that's why it's called the Armageddon War. It will be the final war to end all wars, where the world will turn against the Jews and they will begin to fight the Jewish people to destroy them, to wipe them off the face of the earth. And God himself will split the eastern sky. Watch this now. So he get them to sign a peace treaty. This will happen in the first 3.5 years. The Jews and the Muslims agree to build a temple in Jerusalem. When the temple is built, there will be a dedication ceremony. Listen to what I'm telling you. There will be a dedication ceremony of that temple. When the temple is rebuilt, it will be the greatest news the world has ever heard. It will be the biggest, we call it now, focus on news media worldwide. The temple has been rebuilt in Jerusalem. Do you hear me what I said? There will be a grand day of opening of that temple. This is where Paul says he will go into the temple of God. He himself, Antichrist, will go to the dedication of that temple that's been rebuilt, Solomon's temple. And at some point in there, he's allowed to give a speech. And in that speech, he will declare himself as God in the temple. He shall go into the temple of God and there declare himself as God. He declare himself as God in the temple of God. The moment he does that, the Jews rose up right there on spot and condemn him and call him a heretic and a devil. When the Jews does this, he now switch from a nice guy, that nice peaceful guy, who we have seen doing what he does for the past 3.5 years. He's now switched from a nice guy to the full-blown devil. And he begin to pronounce judgment upon the Jewish people. And there the Armageddon war starts. All these foreign countries, nations, who have benefited from his policy of prosperity and political unity and religious unity, all these nations are going to get so mad at the Jews, they will all gather in the valley of the Armageddon to fight the Armageddon war. And this is how you now have the Armageddon war. It will last for 3.5 years. And the Jewish people are going to be slaughtered by the millions. You ever read in your Bible where it says at midnight there was a cry made? That is a prophetic scripture for the Jewish people where Jesus is saying to them, you have a midnight coming. The midnight is when the nations of the world is fighting them and slaughtering them, and it seems as if they were going to wipe out the entire nation of Israel. The Bible says a cry was made. The Jews are going to cry to Jesus for the very first time, because listen to this. For the very first time, they realize that the Jesus of the Christians is the Messiah of the Jews. For the very first time. No, you know that from the time of Jesus, when Jesus was here, the Jews opposed Jesus. They opposed him. They supported his death on the cross. They inveigled with the Roman soldiers. Pilate, that Jesus should be crucified. So they have been against him all these years. But when the battle of Armageddon starts, and they realize that they are going to be wiped off the face of the earth, there and then the leadership, the religious leaders of the Jews are going to say, you know what? These Christians, by this time, we have already been raptured. The church has already been raptured and gone on to be with the Lord in heaven. And the governments of the world will come up with explanations, some kind of a explanation to make us look like we're stupid. We're hiding in some cave or we commit suicide or whatever. They're going to come up with something to pacify the minds of the people. The Jews are going to say, I wonder if what those Christians has been saying is the truth. I wonder if the Jesus of the Christian is the Messiah of the Jew. And for the first time, somebody say, you know what? Let us cry to him. And this is the midnight cry, the Bible says. At midnight, a cry was made. At midnight, a cry was made. They will cry like they cried in Egypt under Moses. When God rose up Moses to deliver them, they're going to cry like that. A cry that will reach the very heart of God. And this is where the Lord himself, the Bible says, shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel. The world, listen to this. I know some of you may can't believe this, but it's all right. The world will see with their naked eye the Lord Jesus Christ returning to earth as he left to heaven. When he left to heaven, he left from the top of Mount Olives. And the Bible says he went up into the clouds. And his disciples were staring off into the heavens. The scripture said he shall so return in like manner. The very way how he left, That's how he's returning. When he returns, his feet shall touch the top of Mount Olives. And the Bible said he shall enter into the eastern gate of the city. I think it's in Ezekiel chapter 44, if I'm not mistaken. In the book of Ezekiel, I don't remember the exact scripture. It says that the eastern gate will be closed until the return of the Messiah. That gate is closed right now. He shall return in like manner as you have seen him go. You know what the problem is? We believe some parts of the Bible, but we don't believe other parts. I believe the whole Bible. I believe the whole Word of God. And it's not my belief that make it true. I can't believe enough to make it true. It is true whether I believe it or not. The Bible is true whether you believe it or not. It's like saying, okay, I don't believe electricity can shock. I don't believe electricity can shock. You think you can believe, you can wrongly place your belief about electricity, and that is going to change electricity? No. Current is going to shock you if you believe it or not. If you stuck your finger in the socket, it is going to light you up like Christmas tree. Whether you believe it or not, your belief doesn't change the truth. That's what I'm trying to tell you. This generation has been deceived to believe that their belief can change the truth. So if I wake up tomorrow morning and say I'm a rooster, or I'm a ram goat, or I am a cow, I'm a tree, I'm grass, they believe that by believing something they can change the truth. You cannot change the truth. You cannot change the truth. Like you cannot drain the ocean of water. You cannot drain the ocean of water. That's how you cannot change the truth. The truth is independent of your opinion or of your concept, your ideology, or your philosophy. The truth is independent. The truth stands independent. I heard the term from the other day, my truth. You don't have no truth. It is your point of view, my point of view, and then the truth. But I'm going to tell my truth. You don't have no truth to tell. The Bible says all men are liars. That's what the Bible said. All men are liars. So hear me this morning. So I love the Holy Ghost. I love the anointing. I love the Spirit of God. He makes ministry easy. I preach a message this week. The topic was, it's better to hear from God than to speak for God. It's better to hear from God than to speak for God. We have too much people want to speak for God and they have not heard from God. Too much people want to speak for God, want to preach. But they have not heard his voice. But you want to preach. He said, take the word from my mouth. I think he also said that to Ezekiel too. Take the word from my mouth and give them warning from me. Take the word from my mouth, he said, and give them warning from me. Not from you, from him. People of God, listen to what I'm telling you. There is a spirit of Antichrist that has risen in the earth. Very strong, and is working through European people more than any other race of people on earth. This Antichrist spirit is operating through the Europeans more than any other race. The Chinese are communists, but you don't see them pushing this Sodom and Gomorrah thing. The Indian people, they believe in other gods, many different gods, but you don't see them pushing this Sodom and Gomorrah thing. The Spanish people in South America, the American continent, you don't see them pushing it. It's one group of people forcing people. If you don't change your laws, that's what they told Africa, that's what they're telling Jamaica too. If you don't change your laws and live like how we live, go marry to your brethren. Two tough kin men go marry one another. If you don't change your law and do that, then we're going to cut you off. We're going to sanction you. We're going to block your travel. We're going to not renew your visa. This coming from a European mindset. The Europeans were the Roman Empire. The Europeans were the Roman Empire that crucified Jesus of Nazareth. Let me repeat that. Some of you cringing. No, don't cringe. It's the truth. They themselves will tell you. The Roman soldiers were not Chinese. The Roman soldiers were not black people. The Roman soldiers were not Indian people. The Roman soldiers were not Mexican people. The Roman soldiers were not African people. The Roman soldiers were Europeans. They are the ones who crucified Jesus of Nazareth. The devil live among them, you know, and used them more than any other race to perpetrate evil upon this land, the entirety of the world. And it is them today pushing, secretly seducing our government to change the law. You hear me? Hi. Oh, Jesus. Some of you listening to me now. Some of you government people listening. But if you ever change that law in Jamaica, you know what's going to happen. That's why I love my Jamaican people. We may not have much in life, but we now turn we back upon Jah. Bob Marley sing a song, said, Jah live, children, Jah live. Yeah. That's what Bob Marley said, Jah live. We now turn we back on Jah. I said, we're not turning our backs on Jah. You sellout, hypocrite politician, long belly, craven mouth politician. When you see these European, you act like a little child. Like you don't act like you're grown. Mature person, look them in the eye and rebuke them in the name of the Lord and tell them no. You sit there smiley, jokey like it's a joke thing. You tell these reprobate, tell these Sodom and Gomorrah reprobate, go back to your icebox continent where you come from. We're not interested in your lifestyle and your behavior. We're not interested. You all better pray for me. I make up my mind. I made up my mind. It's not easy being in the hot seat. But so help me God. We don't want you to come to our country with your culture. Keep your culture to yourself. You think that we could leave Jamaica and go to France and Germany and all these European countries and tell you guys how to live over there? You're going to take advice from us as black people how to live your life in Europe? You would never listen to us. You think no African leader can leave Africa, fly to Europe and tell you how to live your life in Europe? You will never tolerate that. But you have the nerve, the unmitigated gall. You have the nerve to come to our country, going to Africa, telling people how to live their lives. Want to force people to live the nasty life you have been living. And threatening them. You are the devil. Satan dwell among you. That's the truth. So, why is it that we're seeing this spirit rising up so strong? Because we are approaching the time of Antichrist. Now, there's something I'm going to share with you. A verse of scripture. But I want to find it and then read it for you. And I'm going to show you why there's such a strong atmosphere of the Sodom and Gomorrah lifestyle. Why is there such a strong spirit of it everywhere you go? Why is it so strong? Why is it so oppressive? It's just hanging over. I'm going to show you why. The reason why the Bible says this Antichrist desires not the desires of woman. He doesn't have no desire for woman. He is a homosexual. He is a sodomite. He does not have no desire for woman. And that's why you see the spirit that's in him has gone ahead of him to prepare the stage. The stage is the world, and not just one country. The stage is the world. He already conquered Europe already. This spirit has conquered Europe. Satan has, listen to him, if in the Netherlands, I've never been there, but I've seen news report on it. They have beautiful girls standing in showcases, like glass case, over there in Europe. In the red light district, they have women standing up in Jamaica, we say glass case, showcase, like mannequin, selling their body, and they stand there. These things have been going on in Europe long, long, long ago. The rest of the world is just catching up. Satan have already conquered that continent. And his throne is his base of operation, his headquarters is in that continent called Europe. That's all they're able to produce a man like Hitler. Who wanted to, you hear what Hitler said? He wanted to rule the whole world. But he had to conquer Europe first. If he had conquered Europe, the entirety of Europe and America, he would have conquered the rest of the world. But that's what he said. He wanted to rule the whole world. In 1884, the Europeans met in Berlin, called the Berlin Conference, and there they planned the future of Africa and the future of black people. Let me repeat that. You need to write this down and go research it. In 1884, the nations of Europe met in Berlin, Germany, and there in that meeting, they planned the future of Africa and the African people. They divided the African continent into 54 countries. Up until then, Africa was just one country. It wasn't just one country. But when they met in 1884, they divided the continent into 54 countries. I am telling you about that place called Europe over there. One of these Saturday morning, there's a message I want to preach. The topic is Satan hates black people. You don't want to miss that one. And I'm going to come to you serious, deep with that one, because I can show you from the Bible that the devil hates black people. There's something about black people that the devil hates. Do you know that white people hate the hair, the H-A-I-R, the hair on your head of black people? Do you know that? Do you know if a black woman wear a natural hair and walk into a room full of white women, they all become very uncomfortable? Have you ever stopped to think about that? And say, why is that the case? Why they hate the hair of a black woman so much? There's something about black people that we don't fully grasp. Why is it that a people who are proven to be evil and wicked hate a group of people who don't trouble them? Hate is not of God. So if you hate, you're on the devil's side. Right away we know you are on the devil's side because you hate. Because hate is not of God. The Bible says God is love. So if you hate, you are the servant of the devil. We don't need no rocket science to figure that out. Come back over here. Come back over here. I told you this morning that I have so much thing to say right now. So much thing to say. Spirit of Antichrist has gone ahead of Antichrist. Spirit of Antichrist has gone ahead of Antichrist. And that spirit has gone ahead to prepare the way for Antichrist. He's preparing the stage. They're changing laws. They're changing culture. They're changing human behavior. You see, the atmosphere Antichrist comes into must be an atmosphere of no God. Do you understand what I just said a while ago? The Antichrist, when he comes, he must find a group of people who don't be into God, who hates God like him. So slowly, slowly, they are removing every reference to God out of society. Let me tell you how serious they are about this. They are in labs all over the world changing the genetic makeup of plants. Do you know this? They are genetically altering the genetics or the DNA of plants, of food, of fruits, of even animals. Since this week, they say they were able to manipulate the DNA of human beings in a lab. That came out this week. They were able to manipulate the DNA of human beings in a lab. Mess with your code. Come on, people of God, man. Come on, man. Church is not just a place we go knock tambourine and sing high fly away to glory, go home, and that's church. No, church is knowledge. Church is school. Church, Jesus said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me. Christianity is a school that you never graduate. Learn of me. That's why we have a daily program. Because I love to teach the Bible and I love to share knowledge with the people of God. We must understand things. Jesus taught and preached every day. He taught and preached every day. He gave the people who followed him knowledge, knowledge. Can you imagine this? Every day Jesus taught and preached. Preach and taught and preach. Christianity is not just about running around, shouting hallelujah, speaking in tongues, prophesying and all that stuff. Time and place for everything. Christianity, most of it is about knowledge, the acquisition, the acquiring of knowledge, the knowledge of God, the knowledge of his word, the knowledge of what's going on out there in the dark world. God wants us to understand it from his point of view. I don't study the darkness of the devil from the devil's side. I study it from God's side. I want God show me what's going on over there. Because there are people out there who study witchcraft and obia and study these things to practice it. They study it to practice it. Oh my God, the place is quiet. The whole island is quiet. I saw you must quiet, man. Like all of us quiet right now. I saw we must be quiet in our spirit. So God can talk to us. The Spirit of the Lord can talk to you when you're by yourself. We bring back the knowledge of God, no man. It's not always about drinking and smoking and shaking your butt and shaking your behind in the dance and all that stuff. It's not all. Come on, man. Where is the God part? Where is the God part? Every night you go into a party somewhere. Every night you have a party. Every night. That's lasciviousness. That's wantonness. That's how the people that you were living in the days of Noah, drinking and eating and eating and drinking and merrymaking. No time for God and Bible and prayer and church. Every day you're gone, every day you're dancing, shaking yourself. A new dance here, new dance there, new this there, new. Every day, that's the height of ungodliness. Pleasure seeking. You have a spirit and a soul in your body that need to hear about God. Mr. Dancehall man. You hear me? You have a soul and a spirit in your body that need to hear about God. Shut down everything, man. And go read Bible. Some of you DJs and dancehall people, you have influence over the youths. Why don't you get your Bible and go reason some Bible reasoning with them? It's always about girls and flesh and this and what woman you have and cars you have and Oh, come on. The Bible said in the day, the night coming when no man can work, there will be a day you all am walking with a old with a stick on your back bend, and you're gonna see a pretty girl walk by you, sexy girl, and all you can do is to look. You can't even say hello, good morning, because your voice not strong enough. Solomon had 300 legal wives and 700 concubines. He had 1,000 women living in his palace. None of your so-called galleys out there, you can never, never match up to Solomon. None of you who claim that you're galleys what? You can never match up to Solomon. And Solomon said at the end of his life, he said, vanity of vanity and vexation of spirit. He said, all of this vanity, I had an excess living and lifestyle. He said, made my spirit vex. It cut him off from God. And God warned him. He said, do not fool around with these foreign women. They will turn your heart from me. God told Solomon this in the early days of his ministry. God tell him, said, be careful of these pretty women you have. Because you see, Solomon used to have beauty contests in them. And I'll invite pretty girls from all around, all the different nations to come. And come be a part of the pageantry. And then he chose the prettiest one among them. And he had 1,000 women living in his palace. And at the end of it, Solomon said it was vanity. Vanity of vanity. And it made my spirit vex. Vexation of spirit. Man is not just body and brain. Man is soul and spirit. We need spiritual food. Some of your so-called done man where I run off the place and wanna kill innocent people or murder young ladies because of whatever disagreement, you're killing, everything is kill. You're light, man. You're light. The heaviest thing you have is your gun. You're light. You see, the brain must control the body. The mind must have wisdom and knowledge and understanding to control your temper. If everything, the first thing you want to do is to run to your power source, which is your gun. Everything, every disagreement, you run to your, it means that you are a wild beast out of control. That's what you are. A wild beast. You are no different from a wild animal. Like a bear, a deer, a bear, or a lion, or a hyena. You're no different. Because you can't control your rage. You must be able to control your power, your rage. The Bible said Moses was a very hot-tempered man. But the same Bible said he was the meekest man. Never forget my pastor used to tell us, he said, meekness is not weakness, so-called don, gang man, bad man, whomever you are. Meekness is not weakness. Meekness is power under control. The greatest thing is when a man can control his anger. Jacob cursed Levi and Simeon because they could not control their anger. Do you hear me? I'm talking to you Jamaican brothers who hot-tempered, love to stab, love to shot, love to chop, love to kill. I'm talking to you. Obviously, you can see that I'm not afraid of you. Because you see, once a man loses the fear of death, there's not much you can do to him. Once a man loses the fear of death, the wicked becomes powerless. The murderer becomes powerless. Martin Luther King said, the man who fears death is not free. Martin Luther King says, the man who fears death is not free. You have to lose, and some of you, killers, killy, you are the biggest coward. You're the biggest coward. As you hear somebody and look for bust your head, you run, go hide. But when it's your time to show mercy, you don't show none. That beautiful young lady, you all killed this girl. Whoever killed her. For what? For what? Killing children, killing little girls. Wild beast. You're no different from a wild bear, a wild dog, a wild lion, tiger. You're no different because you have power, but you have no control. A real man is a man who have the power to blow your head off. But he hold himself together and let wisdom control his mind and not anger. Meekness is not weakness. They stole a coaster bus from me in Jamaica. A coaster bus. And the devil brought all kind of thought to my mind. I said, devil, you're a liar. I love God more than that bus. I love Jesus more than that bus. My soul value more than that bus. A house full of expensive utensils and crockery. A thief in preacher stole a whole bunch of those stuff from me. Thief in preacher. Person know themselves. I just walk away and leave all of it. Walk away and leave it. If I ever really tell you my testimony, you will cry for 21 days. You'll cry for me. But I walk away from it because I saw what the devil wanted. He wanted me to defend it. Oh, Jesus, Savior. That devil set a trap. I saw what the devil wanted me to do, to go defend it. I did not even report it to the police. Some of the stuff. I did report about my boss. And the police station told me they would call me. By the way, police station, you know yourself. I'll know you don't call me yet. That's another thing. Oh, God. Can you imagine? The police told me they were going to call me. They'll do their work and call me. I'll know not one phone call has been made. Nobody called me. Leave that alone. You're talking about reason to get violent, reason to be killy-killy. But I look at the old bus and I look at the stuff that I lost. Some of you in Jamaica, you all love studio equipment. A 24-channel mixer board, recording mixer board. 24 channels. A thieving boy and a wicked woman come together and they stole my stuff. I know who is involved in it. I didn't do nothing. I leave it to God. I'm just trying to show you that somebody may have said something to you or whatever. You want to kill the person for that? There are those of us who have lost a lot more than that. But we value our soul more than we value money. I have never lift my hand to do evil. Never been to a obia man. Never shoot or kill anybody. Never. I can lift my hand to God and say, there's no blood on my hands. There's no wickedness on my hands. If you steal anything, don't carry none, come give me. I'm not touching it. Let's leave that alone and come back over here. We're going to have to wrap this up now. What time is it? We're going to have to wrap this up. Time to wrap this up. It's now 8:30. So I have half an hour to go. It's 7:30 there in Jamaica. It's 8:30 here in New York. I want to thank Mr. Shaw. I want to thank the staff that works with him and the patience that he has shown to me. And I know, Mr. Shaw. Thank you so much for being there, standing by me. And you know, I give trouble sometimes, but please thank you for your favor. I've said it before, this man has been far better, more good to me than preachers who I know. This man has helped me many times, patient with me, and be there and help me than preachers I know. And I want to be thankful to God for you, sir, because, you know, you can't take people for granted. And I want to let you know, by the grace of God, this ministry and this man of God respect you and thankful to God for you. And there, I see that there's a respect you have for God that's very deep. There's a respect you have for God, and you want, and a love for the truth of God's word. And there's just something about you that is very old-fashioned and solid, firm. And I really appreciate God for you. People of God, let me try and wrap this up. The culture in Jamaica has changed, but it's not only in Jamaica, it's worldwide. The atmosphere over every country has changed. Changed for the worse. The younger generation is not following the footsteps of their grandparents and their parents. They're going their own way. Through social media has become the new parents. The new parents of the world is social media. And that's what the devil is using most than anything else, is technology. I preached a message last year. The topic was 5G technology for a cashless society. And I was in that message, I talk about 5G. The technology of 5G is a very serious thing, because it is a technology that will enable the government to control your life 100%. Do you hear me? We're going to have to preach on that one of these Saturday morning. But the technology of 5G is the first phase of the new world order, where the government is going to control the lives of the citizens worldwide. The Bible uses a term. It says, you shall not be able to buy nor sell unless you take the mark. The mark of the beast and 5G technology is going to merge. You hear me? When you have some time, go look up the, do a little research on 5G technology. It's not like 4G. It's not like 3G. It's a whole different ball game. 4G cannot handle cashless. The main purpose of 5G is cashless. But there are more things to it than cashless. And it is the first phase. So I mean, 6G is going to come. 7G is going to come. 8G is going to come. There is no end in sight. But this is the beginning stage of a new form of technology, or a higher level of technology. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? It's a higher level of technology. Right now, 4G can only handle a couple of transactions financially and social media and that kind of stuff. But 5G will become your way of spending. When you go to the store to pay for anything, it has to pass through 5G at the speed of a snap of a finger. That's how fast it has to happen. And it can't be no glitch. So this Antichrist is going to use technology to control the lives of humanity. Chip going to be implanted in people's body. A whole lot of things. They're working on a device that can connect to the human brain. So that's where we are. Spirit of Antichrist has infiltrated the entire world. Medicine, education, politics. All of these areas have been affected by the spirit of Antichrist. Everything has been corrupted and polluted and been affected by a spirit of Antichrist. So I close by saying to you, my fellow Jamaicans, we must fight for the culture, our culture, our history, who we are as a people. Do not accept the colonization of Europeans. Cultural colonization. In other words, their culture and the way they live in Europe, They want the rest of the world to live like them. They are not satisfied to just live like themselves among themselves and leave other people alone. No. The rest of the world must conform to the way we live, because they still think they are superior in their minds. So if we're superior, everybody must follow us. And how dare you not following us? And if you don't follow them, they start calling your names. You remember with the vaccine, they were calling you what? There's a term they use to mock you. They say you are something that a vaxxer, a no vaxxer. I forgot the term, but there was a nickname they gave people who did not take the vaccine, no vaxxer, whatever it was. They were giving people a nickname who didn't take the vaccine, bullying you to bow down to them. Listen to me, Jamaican people, let's stand up for God and resist European culture. This Sodom and Gomorrah thing is a European spirit. It's coming out of Europe to America, then the rest of the world. Stand up for God and the Bible. Stand up for God and the Bible. Stand up for God and the Bible. And let us maintain our respect and love for Almighty God. Now, there are unsaved people listening to me right now, and backsliders that are listening to me. Some of you are hearing me for the very first time. We have been on Best FM from 2011. Sometimes we get off for various reasons sometimes, and we are back on. We are taking a break at one point, but we are back on. You're listening to me for the very first time. We are here every Saturday morning from 6 o'clock Jamaica time, 7 o'clock New York time. I want you to join me. Those of you listening for the first time, driving in your car, at home, wherever you're at, we are here every Saturday morning, starting 6 o'clock Jamaica time, 7 o'clock here in New York. I want you to join me. I have a lot of things I want to share with you from the Word of God. I have nothing new to tell you. I'm just telling you the whole story with a voice that may not sound familiar to you, but it's the same old story. I don't have no new gospel to give you. The gospel don't need to be modernized. The gospel is already what it is. But I want you to join me on Saturday morning, my fellow Jamaicans. Join me on Saturday morning. We have some serious things to talk about. We're going to talk Bible. We're going to pray. And we are going to love God, and we're going to serve God. We're not going to hell. I was talking to a lady the other day, and I said, ma'am, she's from one of those islands. And we were talking, and I said, ma'am, do not let them take your soul. And she got very quiet, and she was listening. I said, my sister, do not let them take your soul away from you. Don't let them take your soul. And that's the word I'm going to leave with you this morning, my fellow Jamaicans. Do not let them take your soul. Do not let them take the soul of your children. I'm gonna title this video with that title. Do not let them take your soul. Hollywood, don't let Hollywood take your soul. Don't let these Europeans with their cultural perversion come take your soul. No. Don't let these politicians take your soul. Don't let the gangs take your soul. Don't let the Don take your soul. Do not let them take your soul. Whatever you do, stay flat-footed, remain flat-footed for God. Firm. Stand up for Jesus. Ye soldiers of the cross, lift high his royal banner. It must not suffer loss. Do not let them take your soul. Do not let them take your soul. I say one last thing, and then I go to the music. Election is coming up. Any government or potential government that wants to rule our country, and if they don't have the courage to tell the Europeans no, and to maintain our culture the way we knew it all these years, then fire them in the election. Fire them. any one of them supporting corruption and nastiness. Don't be loyal to no party. Be loyal to righteousness, what is just before God, what is right in the sight of God. That's what you must be loyal to. Be loyal to Almighty God. Any one of them down there with going on with corruption, get rid of them. Don't be loyal to, I am not loyal to no political party. I look for the man who is doing his best to tell the truth and uphold the truth and stand for what's right. That's the man I support. I don't care what side of the fence he's on. Do not let them take your soul. Do not let them take your soul. God gave you 2 eyes, 2 hands, 2 feet, one nose with 2 nostrils, 32 teeth in your head, but he gave you 1 soul. Do not let nobody take your soul.
The other day, I was doing an interview. Young man that was interviewing us knew a lot about the mighty clouds. He said to me, "Joe, you've been singing 30 years now. He said, what were some of the most memorable things that has happened in your career?" He began to name some things that I had forgot about. He said, was it the time that you stood on the shores of Switzerland, England, Africa, even Japan? He said, was it the time when you sang for the president of the United States? And I said, no. I said, the most memorable thing that I can think of was in Rochester, New York. A young man came in the program one evening and said, who is Joe Lagan, the mighty clown? He'd never seen us, but he heard our records. He said, I want to talk to you. When he met me, he said, I was so down in my life at one time. I lost my wife and I lost my job and had a lot of children to try to take care. He said, I got so low till I went in the room one day and got a gun. I was going to kill my children and then kill myself. He said, but through your records and your singing, I'm saved today. And I told the man that was doing the interview, I said, that's the most important thing that has happened in my career. A man found Jesus through our singing. I never will forget that. When he told me he was saved, I want to sing a song that says these words. Michael, if you will.
I've got one thing you can't take away.
I like that. Listen, it's good to know you got Jesus in your life. People can take a lot of things away from you. They can take your automobile. They can take your home. If you whoop your children one time too many, they can take your child away from you. But if you got Jesus, can't nobody take him away from you. I believe somebody here got the Lord today. Do you have him in your life? Ain't it good to know you got it? Ain't it good to know you got Jesus? Somebody feel good like I do. I'm glad I got something. Do you have something that can't nobody? Let me tell you what I got. Let me tell you. Oh, 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 oh. I got
Jesus.
It's an appropriate way, a beautiful way to end the program this morning. Thank you, Jamaica, for listening to me. Thank you, Best FM, for bringing our broadcast. And I hope and trust this morning that the Spirit of God will move upon your heart and touch your life in a supernatural way. I want to invite you to join me weekday mornings, Monday to Friday. We go live on our network. We have a network, Heart for God Network. You could download our ministry app on Google Play or the App Store. Download our ministry app by typing my name into Google Play or the App Store. Pastor Howard Palmer or Howard Palmer Ministries. Howard Palmer Ministries or Pastor Howard Palmer. Go to the Google Play or the App Store and type my name in there and install the app. Now, this ministry app, we stream and rebroadcast, and it's a radio and a TV app, television and radio app. We broadcast 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. We broadcast each weekday morning, Monday to Friday, 5 a.m. Jamaica time, 6 a.m. here in New York. We go for 3 hours every weekday morning with the program Manna in the Morning. Manna in the Morning. Join me each weekday morning for the program Manna in the Morning. I'm inviting you to do that. So it's simple. Go to Google Play. Do it now. Do it right now if you can. Go to Google Play Store or the App Store and install our ministry app to your phone by typing in Howard Palmer Ministries or Pastor Howard Palmer. Palmer is spelled P-A-L-M-E-R. Join me. Don't mix next week Saturday morning. By the help of the Spirit, I want to talk to you about black people are programmed to self-destruct. Black people are programmed to self-destruct. That's what I want to talk to you about Saturday morning coming, God's willing. If the Holy Ghost change it, then that's His doings. But there's a lot, as I said, I want to share with you, all right? So go to the ministry app and to the App Store or the Play Store and install the ministry app to your phone, all right? And catch us 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. More so on weekday mornings, Monday to Friday, 5 a.m. Jamaica time, 6 a.m. New York time. 3 hours of Manna in the Morning. If you're not saved this morning, I want you to pray this prayer with me. I want to pray for those of you who are not saved. You're not saved, you're listening to this broadcast, and you have been touched by the Spirit of God, and you want to give your heart to God. You may be in the jailhouse, you may be a police officer, you may be a doctor, you may be a taxi driver, wherever you are in society. You feel that the Lord is dealing with your heart and in your life, and you want to give your heart to God. I want you to pray this prayer with me right now. Just pray this prayer with me right this very minute, and surrender your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ. Say, Dear Heavenly Father, I acknowledge that I am a sinner and I need to be saved. I invite you into my heart right now to wash me in your precious blood and to make me a child of God. Lord, I repent of all my sin. I surrender my life to you, Lord. I want to be in that number when the saints go marching in. In the name of Jesus Christ, I give you my life. I give you my heart. In Jesus' name. Now let me pray for you. Lord, I pray for every unsaved and backslider who have prayed the prayer, Lord, and has surrendered their heart to you. Jesus, I'm asking you to save them at the cross. Wash them in your precious blood. Write their names down in the Lamb's Book of Life. And cover them under your blood today, Lord. Receive them to yourself in the name of Jesus. And glorify yourselves in their lives. Oh God, I give you praise for all that you have done and all that you are going to do in Jesus' name. Now, if you need to get in touch with me, I'm going to give you my WhatsApp number, 516-499-1383. 516-499-1383. That's 516-499-1383.
When he told me he was saved, I want to sing a song that says...
We won't be able to take your calls this morning, but as of next week, we'll begin to take your call. Let's let the Spirit do what the Spirit is doing right now. Thank you, everybody, for listening to me. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you, Best FM. I catch you again next week, Saturday morning, 6 a.m. Jamaica time, 7 a.m. here in New York. Until then, Pastor Howard Palmer saying to you, it is in the pursuit of God. Purpose and destiny for a man's life is discovered. We love you.
Listen, it's good to know you got Jesus in your life. People can take a lot of things away from you. They can take your automobile. They can take your home. If you whoop your children one time too many, they can take your child away from you. But if you got Jesus, can't nobody take him away from you. I believe somebody here got the Lord today. Do you have him in your life? Ain't it good to know you got it? Ain't it good to know you got Jesus? Somebody feel good like I do. I'm glad I got something. Do you have something that can't nobody? Let me tell you what I got. Let me tell you. Oh! Traveling journey, it's not always easy for me. Sometimes I have to cry. Sometimes when I sing, folks look at me and act like they don't know what I'm singing about. But I got to sing on. Make me think about Johnny Martin right now. Before he left, he told me, "Child of God, keep your head in God's hand. Don't worry about what people say about you. Don't worry when they talk about you. God will make a way for you. Ain't God good? Ain't God?
If you're walking up the king's highway, yeah.
few more times this year.
This young lady who's going to sing is Santita Jackson, Reverend Jesse Jackson's daughter. She sings gospel too. And guess what? She's singing a song that I didn't write either. It was written by Bill Gaither. Sing, Santita.
Someone said that in each life somewhere is bound to fall. heart is and the troubles us all. But the hurt can't hurt forever, and the tears are sure to dry, and it won't rain always. The clouds will soon be gone. That sun
I had nothing but heartaches and trouble. I was seeking for fortune and fame. I had nothing but doubts and but now I have everything. I was making big plans for my future. I was living my lifetime in vain. Then I prayed for life's only meaning, and now I have everything. I have everything I need to make me happy. Jesus to show me the way. He has saved me and gave me life eternal. And now everything I need to make me happy. I have Jesus to show me the way. He has saved me and gave me life